the rubber band technique for putting your sinker on so you do not damage your line. And what do we use this for? Is for when the bluefin's marking under the boat at 100 feet plus under the boat. At that 60 or 50 foot level, you really don't need the rubber band. But once it gets to 100 or below, why do we put a rubber band on the line to hold the sinker? Because we don't want to damage the line. And then in the middle of the fight, the fish will shake this right off the line and break the rubber band. It's pretty cool. 99.9% of the time when you bring your bluefin in, the sinker's no longer on the line. We don't have to tie another knot into the line to put the sinker on. We simply attach the sinker with the rubber band by placing the rubber band through the eye of the torpedo sinker. So we have it going through there. We just stick it back through the rubber band itself, the rubber band, and that brings it down and ties it on to with no knot. Now we take this. What I do is I use braided line with a small piece of fluorocarbon going to my hook. Okay? Not a very long piece. 18 to 24 inches is all I use. Just a very small piece of fluorocarbon going straight to my braid. This is how I fish. This isn't how everybody fishes, but this is how we do it. All our reels on our boat are filled with braided line. We just use this small piece of fluoro because I believe that the fish can see the braided line, but they can't see the piece of fluoro. And you gotta remember, these fish are very finicky sometimes, the bluefin, so you wanna go as stealth as you can. I'm gonna use a black or bronze hook because of the fact that when the hook hits the water, it's invisible. And then I'm gonna use a short piece of mono or fluoro. If you think you need fluoro, then you gotta have fluoro. Then I'm just gonna attach it to the line with the RP knot. And then I'm gonna take my rubber band sinker and I'm gonna hook it right at the braid, right where the knot is, okay? And I'm gonna stick the hole of the rubber band around the braid. Then I'm gonna stick the sinker back through the hole. If you look at it, it's gonna come down on the knot. Why on the knot? That way it doesn't have a tendency to slip down onto your hook, because it could still slip up and down the line, but I tie it right to the knot so that it doesn't slip. Does that make sense, guys? Now, you can drop this down 100 feet to that tuna with your bait nose hooked. Not in the back, not in the side, but nose hook your mackerel or your sardine side to side through his nose. Why? Because when it's dropping down, it can get bit. How many of you have been bit on the sink or been bit on the wind? That's because the bait looks natural. It looks like it's swimming down or it looks like it's swimming up. But if you hook it in the back or in the tail, now you've taken yourself out of the game while you're dropping it down, and you've taken yourself out of the game when you're winding it up, because there's no bait in the world that swims butt first or back first. I never seen a fish swimming back first. They all swim nose first, so that's why I'm going to hook it side to side through the end of the nose. I'm going to drop it down with my sinker that's just simply put on the line by the rubber band. Then when the fish bites, it starts to shake violently. 90% of the time it'll pop that rubber band right off, the sinker will go away, and all you have is 100 pound plus bluefin on the end of your line. All right, guys, hopefully that works for you. Good luck out there. Let us know how you do.